Hello, welcome to my studio. I'm Sarah, and in this video, I'm trying out the art challenge where you draw something inspired by song lyrics using the color scheme of the album art. I'm not going to say the lyrics now, because I'm not totally sure how YouTube's copyright system works for that, but they are going to be written on the final piece. I guess I'll talk about the lyrics vaguely in the meantime. The first song is Lights Shine Bright by Toby Mac. It talks about being a light for Jesus and reflecting his light to the whole world, especially through music. At least that's my take on it. I redid the eyes to match my reference a little bit better, although I kinda liked the stylized ones a bit more. Oh well. This hat was so hard to draw. Getting the angle of the brim right was really tricky. I'm using Toby Mac himself as my model. I didn't quite match his likeness, but I honestly wasn't really focusing on that. I tried to have a bit of perspective on the arms, as if they're angled towards you. I had to fix my first attempt because the elbows were too high though. So I'm basing this drawing off of the first verse of the song in particular. It mentions diamonds reflecting and magnifying God's light. I had the idea to draw someone holding a big diamond, except the person is in black and white, and the diamond is reflecting the true colors back. The album art is black and white with some glitchy rainbow stripes, so that fits the color scheme part of the art challenge. Figuring out the shading was fun. I've never shaded a face where the only light source is from below. In this case, the diamond is the source. So this was a fun twist. I tried to keep the planes of the face in mind, specifically the cheek and brow bones. A lot of things I would usually add shadows to are now flipped with the highlights. I started with a mid-tone and then worked getting the shadows darker and darker from there. For now, I'm going to let everything blend into soft edges, but I'll leave hard shadows later to give more depth. Since I use this blending stump so much, it actually added some graphite to places I wanted to leave highlights, so I'm erasing some parts a little bit. The highlights really pop when everything else is shaded darker. When it comes to shading, you can't be afraid of your darkest darks. If I left this drawing the way it is now, it would be pretty flat. You really want to define the folds and the casted shadows. High contrast between lights and darks gives it three-dimensionality. I used the bright rainbow colors on the diamond, and added some highlights within it to try and give it a shiny, faceted look. It reminded me of a beach ball before I added the details. I hadn't really given much thought as to what color I wanted his jacket to be. I think I'll make it a leather jacket. There's no brown on the album cover, but black wouldn't really pop with the grayscale. I start by laying down the shadow color, which I then blend out with the main color. Now I'm adding a few darker shadows where I feel like they're needed. I took a bit of a risk and did streaks of the diamond colors into the rest of the colored areas. I'm not really sure what I think of it. It looks a bit better blended out. The second drawing is inspired by the song Bulletproof by Citizen Way. The first verse talks about how there are arrows from the past, how it felt like there was no hope to move on. But now that they have the armor of God and nothing, no fears or doubts, can truly hurt them anymore. My concept for this song was a man wearing medieval style armor, and that there is a faded, like, ghost of what this man used to be, that's defeated and ready to give up. Again, I'm using the lead singer as my reference, but this drawing is way more stylized and doesn't really capture his likeness, it's mostly just in the hairstyle. Behind this ghost, there's a real version of him, standing tall and ready against the arrows. This drawing looks very different from the other one. I think I was subconsciously rushing a bit to try and get this video done. I really don't want drawing to become a chore for videos. I made a community post about this, but if you missed that, I'm going to be changing my posting schedule from a video every week to posting every other week. I was planning to change the schedule anyways, once the school year started again. For the first try of the legs, there was this weird discontinuity, and they were too far to the side. I still wish I had widened his stance a bit more than I did. The pose itself feels pretty stiff to me. I guess I can at least change the position of the arm a bit. I definitely could have done better by making the whole thing more dynamic. Why is it always that you love the sketch and then the line art messes it up? I was decently happy with the face of the right man in the sketch. It wasn't perfect, but it's an angle I don't draw very often. Something with the line art and the eyes just looks really weird. Just gotta keep drawing. The colors on the album cover are red and different shades of warm gray. I think watching the marker fill in the colors at this speed is really satisfying. I'm really trying to push the faintness of this, so I went over the whole thing with a colorless blender to lift some of the color. It gives it a more see-through look by making the opacity lighter. This drawing I'm doing with mainly just markers. It's been a while since I've used markers for shading and not just the base colors. Like with the color pencils earlier, I put down the shadow colors and then go back with the main color to blend out the edges that I want to soften. Metal is fun to shade. There are lines of darks and lights, sometimes jarringly right next to each other. That contrast is part of what makes it shiny. I'm learning more how to shade clothes, especially draping fabric like this tunic. There are lots of diamond and V shapes that angle with the weight of the fabric. I want to keep the kneeling man pretty pale, but I still wanted some shading, so I went over again with the same colors to layer some shadows now that the first layer was dry. Adding highlights with a white gel pen is so much fun. Now the metal looks very shiny. I used a white pencil to add even lighter highlights to the faint man, and then used the colorless blender to blend it out. Colorless blenders can work really well to blend colored pencils. The reds needed to go even darker. That really added the depth that the tunic was missing. Blending that darker red in, I left some edges hard to show that that part of the fabric is overlapping, compared to blending it out, which shows that it's a dip that light isn't hitting. I hope that makes sense. I went ahead and added darker shadows to the rest of him too. I don't know, what do y'all think? This challenge definitely pushed me. It was really hard to put the concept I had in my head on paper, and honestly, neither of them turned out quite the way I imagined. But that's okay. I've been a bit burnt out from drawing the past couple of weeks, and I feel like that shows a bit, but they're not the worst. Anyways, thank you so much for sticking around to the end. If you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments, and I will try to answer them. Jesus loves you.